God's battle will keep.
Welcome to the channel, and today I'm gonna teach you how to make your PC perform better than before, have more frames per second in your games, and sorry my voice is bad, I'm not audible, but please just try to bear with me. And also, yeah, enjoy the video. Yep, and the PC I'm using here is an Intel Celeron CPU, second gen, and it's clocked at 1.8 GHz, and the RAM is 2 GB, which is really really poor for gaming performance, but I'm gonna show you that it actually does good in game. Step 1, go to your library. Properties with your PC, advanced system settings. I don't know, many people have done this and I don't think it actually helps the performance, but you know, let's do it, right? Let's do it. And you go to visual effects here, adjust for better performance, just click it and everything will be done for you here. Don't worry, you don't need any of this for your games, I'm sure it's for gaming, okay? Then you come here, custom size. They say use your RAM and your everything they were talking is bullshit, so just use any free space you have to help your PC. I use 8 GB to support it and set it to 8 GB, and okay, yeah, that's good. So you're done with that, and can't close this out now, and make sure you have above 10 GB free your hard disk where your games are installed. This is my hard disk here, and this is where my games are installed, so I have, you know, I have some free space here in my game folder. Secondly, let's talk about the main stuff. As you know, or you don't know, Windows 10 Pro is the best OS for gaming because it provides more performance in gaming with DirectX 12, and it comes with better optimizations for games. Trust me, I've used all the OS in the world for Windows. I've used all of them, and the best is Windows 10 Pro. Trust me. Now, you want to make sure that you have a very good game driver for your CPU. If you're using an Intel HD graphics CPU, oh man, I'm talking bullshit, you know. If you're using an Intel HD graphics, you know, GPU, which don't have a dedicated GPU, it's not iGPU, so you have to go to, I have one file here I used to mod mine, it's called it's among the file with the link in the description below, so you have to go and check it out. So yeah, once you're sure that you have downloaded that file from the link below, don't worry, once you have downloaded the file from the link below, and copy the file, you know, to somewhere you like most. I recommend that you copy it to your local disk and make a folder there, because your antivirus and everything doesn't interfere, and also turn your antivirus off so it doesn't delete any of the files. So if you open this file, extract here, you're gonna see the folder, open it. Now, these are everything you need to make your PC perform better. Actually better. Like I've seen the good performance. I'm gonna open this up. Now I wanna click next. Next. Agree. Next. Install it. Next. Yes. Start. When it's installed, click next. Exit. Now go to your desktop. Do you see this folder there? This one. And yep, open it up. Pause. Now you won't be able to take your CPU if you don't run this software with administrator privileges. So I'm gonna use your, just wait, you see, you need to use one click. This is a mod driver for your graphics card, for your GPU, your iGPU, IntelliJ graphics. Yep, get started. Yep, you see, make sure that you run this as admin, so you don't run phone as admin, because you didn't do it before, I'm sure. Now, get started. Okay. If you're using any of these graphics cards, it should literally give you more FPS in games, like 10 FPS, literally give you 10 FPS. First gen Intel HD graphics, you use that because I'm using. Well, I've already done all this, so when you do grab it, this is going to take you to your website where you download the driver. Then you run it as an administrator and install it. This is for 2000 generation and above, second gen, third gen, fourth gen. Yep, that's all you need. Now, wait, don't do that yet. Just keep calm. I know you want to do this immediately, you lost weight. Open your DXDR. This is going to show you the information of your drivers, your GPU driver, your CPU drivers, and this is going to show you, yeah, everything you need to know about it. Once you have clicked that, you're gonna see this window, DirectX DIAG 2, so I call it. This tool reports detailed info about DirectX components, drivers, and storage system. So, yep, this is mine. This is the second gen CPU I was telling you about. 2 gigs of RAM, page file used. So, you see that that file, with that your page file you are located to our RAM. You can see it right here, that this is the one your PC is using. So I just gave it enough in case of anything. So as you can see, it's still loading. So when that finishes loading, okay, you can now see all your info, everything about your PC. This is my clock right now, boost clock. This is everything about your PC. So if you come here and you see that you don't find your Intel, your graphics card information here, your CPU graphics, your iGPU to display, did you find it here? Intel HD graphics. This is the basic first gen Intel HD graphics, so we should come here, first generation Intel HD graphics, and grab it. But if you have like any other graphics like 2K, 4000, but if you have a fifth gen Intel HD, I don't think there's something like that, but it should be like, I don't know, but I know that you have Intel UHD or the most. If you have that one, I'm sorry, just skip this step, okay? But if you have above 5000 and you want to use this fourth gen Intel HD graphics driver, you have like 5500, 6K, just use this one, it's gonna work. Now, when you finish doing that, you close up this bullshit, let's get to the next step. Yep. Yeah, so make sure that everything here is enabled. D3D acceleration enabled, AGP texture enabled, and everything. Well, I don't think you can change it, but it should be enabled if you're using the little driver. As you can see in this PC here, the display, the VRAM is 64 MB, and this 1 GB dedicated. Yep, and this is not display. I just reduced the resolution to be able to record and get more smoothness of this video. I hate this PC, trust me. So when you're done, you close that up. Now, step two, you want to make sure that you have uninstalled any app you're not using, like Bloatware or anything. But if you download the Windows 10 Lite from, I don't know. If you want to upload it, just say it in the comments and I'll upload the Windows 10 Lite for you. It's very compressed and it's actually good performing. The main Windows 10 was like using 1.5 gig to 2 gig of RAM, okay. But with this custom version of Windows 10, I get about more. I'm using 2 gig RAM this laptop, okay. But when the laptop is idle or gaming, I have like 1 gig free, which is very 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 very, very good for the game, okay. So we're gonna come here, gaming. Sorry that the PC is performing very very slowly, just sorry, endure. Turn this off. Turn this off. Come to game mode here. Turn this off too, because this actually reduces your FPS, okay? Go to graphics. Make sure that any game you install should be here and set to high performance, okay? Any game you install should be here and set to high performance. And it actually helps. So when you're done with that step, you want to also uninstall apps you're not using, because they actually do, you don't know what they're doing in your background. So I'm gonna go to, yeah, actually I've seen the effect of this. Yeah, so I'm gonna go to your programs and files, and yep, go to Windows system control panel. You want to go to programs, uninstall a program. Now you're gonna see all the software you've installed in your PC. Now you have to make a choice of uninstalling the one you want to uninstall, removing the ones. Actually, I've already done that in this PC, so I don't think there's anything here. As you can see, there's no bloatware here again. I don't have Windows Music, all that crap, Explorer. Okay, I have Edge actually. But everything is what I installed personally. I kept the camera because I need the webcam for my recording. Discord, nothing, no bloatware here. I put this on personal because I need it. And yeah, when you're done with that step, hop up to the next step. Hop now in this step. You want to make sure that you install all your games to the root of your hard disk, because installing your games to folder, linking them folder to folder, or installing them to program files are risking your game files to antivirus, virus, and actually for the game to read the file that is being provided, that will slow it down. So I advise you to install your games here, local disk, make a new folder here, and that should be where your important files are. Like here, my downloads, these are my games that I'm playing right now. I should play them. So all these games here, no one has a problem because of that. Okay, this is actually a PS 2021 patch, because this PC can play PS 2021 original version. So if you don't mind, yeah, this is where all your software should be, your games, everything you're gonna be playing. This is my second folder for games, okay. Yeah, so when you're doing that step, hop to the next step, bro. Now in this step, this is where things begin to get really 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 good. This is where the main video starts. Now this is the pack with the link in the description below. When you download that file, you're gonna have all these files here, okay. Now you're going to open, you're gonna extract this MSI util. This actually is the, let's say, the foundation of all the game performance you have. Let's open that as an admin. When this opens, you're gonna see this window. Yes, this window. So you want to make sure that everything is set to undefined. Like, go and make everything undefined first. Everything should be like this: undefined, undefined, and undefined. Okay, When you have done that, you come to your Intel HD graphics, Intel HD graphics, then you see your generation here, okay? Come to the priority, Intel priority, head to high. Go to your Intel processor, I don't know what we'll call it, your CPU, you should know the name, okay? Come here, set it to high. If you want to use your mouse for your wireless mouse for gaming or your wired mouse for more DPI FPS games, put this in normal, okay? Then, when that is done, I think you're good to go. Apply this, refresh again, make sure that everything inside you kept it, keep refreshing like 5 times. Till you see that it doesn't change, okay? It's good. Now I'm gonna close this up. And now, next step. Let's go to the next step. Now, you're gonna want to install Power Control. This is from Bitsum. Thanks to Bitsum for providing the software. Link in. The link for the file, for the whole package, is in the description below. Actually, I've already installed this file, so. After installing this, you should see this. Yes, you see this file. You see this window here. Power Control, CPU packing, application scaling. Disable this. Disable. Apply. Make sure that everything is tuned to 100%. 100%. 100. 100. Everything should be at 100%. Everything should be at 100. Apply this. Once you're done with this step. Okay, you close it and make sure that it doesn't shine, it doesn't show red color. If you're showing a red color here, you have a really, really big problem, which will fix it in the future. But make sure that this should be showing blue, like never show red, like just constant blue. That means that all your CPU cores are active and it doesn't reduce your performance. Okay, now next step, memory duct. This is provided by Bitsum 2. I don't know whether it's Bitsum. I don't know. But yes. So I have already installed this, so I'm not going to install it again. So I'm gonna close it. When you install that, you just see this window. Yes, this window. When you install it, you should see this window here. Memory docked. Come here. Settings. You go to settings, you go to confirm memory clean start, file, settings, go to memory cleaning, okay, skip user account control from to on, check that, okay, when you've done that, just check everything you see on the screen right now, memory cleaning, working set, excuse me, system working set, standby list without priority, then turn this one on too, but just know that when you do this, it's gonna freeze your PC for like 10 seconds, okay? You do this one too, yes. Then if you're using Windows 10 Plus, which is gonna be very good, turn that on too. And then put this clean when it is above 95%, because when you do that, when your PC goes very high and it's performing too much, and you clean memory immediately, it performs better, okay? Then maybe if you're gaming and you want your game to be smoother, or just want to, don't know, it's your choice, but if you want to do it, you just come here and put this hotkey for yourself. Or I'm not gonna use that, okay? I'm gonna close that right now. And but I won't do it because this might actually crash my Bandicam, so sorry. But I'll just do that, okay? Now, the next step. In this step, I'm gonna show you how to make your PC, your CPU's base clock increase to the maximum clock actually. So you want to extract this file here, quick CPU setup. You open it, prepare to install. When you get to this place, you install it, next, and yep, install it, and yeah, right. When you finish installing it, you should see a window like this. Yes, something like this. It's loading right now, so just chill, take a chill pill and just wait. When you first open to this quick CPU, this should be different. The core packing should be minimal, everything should be different, okay? Well, if it's like this, like maximum, you know that you've already done this before, so that's good. This now will give you minimum performance. If you would like want to watch movies with your laptop, want to watch movies or want to browse, surf the web or any just minimal things, you come here and you enable minimum performance, okay? Then if you want a smooth performance for just typing, just minimal something, you will use this one, balanced performance. But if you want, yeah, you know that, okay, maximum performance for game and everything, you click there, everything should be ticked right except this one, accept. Then this should trigger your brightness and everything to maximum, and this is going to actually give you more game performance. Apply this. Okay, now you see this is my frequency right now. It's 2.0 GHz. This is the clock base frequency and this is the real time frequency. That means it's clocked to maximum. Okay, this is this is your graphics card code name. You want to know about that, so keep it somewhere, okay? And everything needs to be 100%. Everything needs to be maximum. Apply that. Okay, I think you're good to go right now. Now everything you're gonna do from now on will make your gaming more smoother, like more constant frame per second and everything. Close this up. Now the next step is that you're gonna have to open this lasso bullshit. I don't know, actually this is the cracked version of the app because I didn't pay for it. So you want to copy this to your desktop, okay? Paste it here or put it here in your tags bar and keep it there for future use, because you don't want to be going to your file manager or your Windows Explorer to be opening it. So just keep it here, okay? Now open it up and to ask for your privileges. When you open this up, this is what you should see, like straight from the box. So the reason why my one is dark is because I turned up my dark mode, which I have forgotten how I did. Let me check. Yeah, right, I don't know, I've forgotten how I turned that on. Dark mode, of course it's cool, right? Yep, colors dark. This is how you should be, but I don't fancy this color, so I go for dark. Now go to active processes, click on it and make sure that you have turned on performance mode. If you want to turn this on, go here, right click on this and click on this performance mode and ensure that it's ticked on. Don't turn anything on again unless you want to minimize your FPS, which is not gonna be good. And this should be on, performance mode should be on. This should be at 100 to 50% responsiveness. This should be above 50% sometimes in your game, and this should be okay. When you have this, go to your main here, click on main, keep PC awake indefinitely. When you do this, your PC won't sleep, so this will keep PC active for gaming, okay? Active power profile, leave it in quick CPU, don't change it, just leave it here, okay? Keep PC awake indefinitely. Performance mode turned on. Now this is the next step. Options, general settings. When you come here, no sorry, options, okay, options, click on it. What the fuck is this? CPU, Okay. Configure CPU limiter and make sure everything here is blank. Okay. Clear all. Then we cancel. Yes, save changes. Options again. General settings. Refresh interval 1 second. Okay. Options. Power. Performance mode. This is really, really, really key to your game. Options. Power. Performance mode. Designate high performance processes. When you open this, you're going to have to look for all the games you're playing. Right, click on this 3-dot option file. Fuck. 3-dot option icon. Go to where all your games are installed. Click on them each one by one. And select the exe file of the game you're playing. Add. And this should be provided here. And you cancel. Save changes, yes, or you press OK, yes, and add it. Now, after adding all your games there, don't forget I told you, make sure all your games are located in your local disk in a folder, so the games won't have any problems. The next step, after doing the other steps, this is another key step. Close that lasso. If you close it, it should be running here. So make sure it's running here. Okay. Now, Intel driver and support assistant installer. If your driver is not giving what you want, actually, I've shown you guys how to install the mod drivers. But if you want that step, you can just come here and install this Intel driver and support assistant. And this should help you locate the driver you're gonna use for your graphics card, your monitor, and everything. Okay, and make sure that you're connected to the internet to be able to install that driver. Okay, the next step. Now, in this step, you're gonna go to CC Cleaner or C Cleaner, what you can call it, and install it like that. Okay, make sure that you follow all my instructions. The password for this file is 123. The password for this file is 123. 123. Very easy. 123, like ABC. Okay. And this should install. This should extract. You open it up. You install this first. Actually, just come here in the README I provided and read everything here. Save your internet. Use KeyGen and everything. And yeah, these are my free bonuses for you for watching this video. And if you enjoyed the video so far, don't forget to like and subscribe, because from now on I'll be doing more tricks and tips. Actually, I've watched many videos, Close Spec Gamer, Levitation Body, and I think I have all their videos in one video. So subscribe to me for more of these tips. Okay, the next step. Now, you want to extract this DXCPL, right? Extract here. Open. Yes. So when this is open, alright, this is going to help you do nothing. Just make sure that it's turned off, because I watched many videos that this helps you in providing FPS and everything, but I'm sure most of you mistakenly turned this on. But please make sure that you turn this off. Okay, turn this off, because this is a virus. This is not going to help you. It's not a virus, but it's not going to help you in your game performance. Make sure this is turned off. I'm just being a good boy. Okay, now I think we've pretty much done everything that will help you in providing more FPS. So now, the next step: open your CCleaner after installing this provided with me here. When you open your CCleaner, you should see it in your desktop like this icon. Okay, you open it up. When you open your CCleaner, you should find this window telling you your specs and your Windows OS. Now click on skip to start health check. Okay, it will check your PC's health. Actually, I advise you to connect to the internet, so it actually helps you unclean your browser, virus and everything. This is the best antivirus I've ever seen, and I like it because it's actually doing a work of. I've heard many antivirus, Avast, Norton, McAfee, they just take more RAM and waste their time there. But this one and your Defender is already good to go. Don't have any more antivirus than this, because that's just a waste of time. And also, I told you, make sure that after doing this, I didn't tell you, after doing this, you turn on your Windows Security real-time protection. Turn it on because it actually helps your PC. This is the best antivirus you can ever have. Your Windows Security is the best you can ever have, okay? So make sure you also always turn it on before playing games. I'm sorry we are 30 minutes into the video, but just trust me that everything I'm saying here is worth it. The video will be done, okay? I don't know, after this CCleaner update, anytime you want to check your PC's health, actually just get stuck here. So cancel it. Next, like this. I think now it should be faster and it should exceed that place you stopped. That should happen on your first run, okay? But now it should pass. I think this is where it was before, with this icon. Watch it pass. So I don't know, I've waited for a long time, like 5 seconds. It's still here, so I'll minimize this. Now I think everything you need to know about your gaming performance and everything should be alright, already done by now. I advise you to watch other videos because they actually help you, and this is low spec experience. I will provide the link below. Click on that and install it, and any game you have and you want to get more FPS in that game, just open this, allocate the game, and yeah, when you watch the video below, I think should help you. This is how it looks like. After 30 years of waiting, it's actually finished, so you click on make it better. Then this should be very fast, patching up your PC, which didn't have a cut somewhere. Yep, there you go. It's gonna be very, very fast right now. When you open the lowest spec experience, the free edition, the free version, I'll provide the link to download it in the description below. Go to optimization catalog here, look for the game you want to play. I didn't see all the games I want to play here, so don't just be aware. I have a game here. I have the original Modern Warfare 1 here. Okay. Then you load the package. Then this should automatically look for the games. But if it can't find the game, it will tell you, it will prompt a window like this. Unable to verify the game version, okay? So you press OK. Now you have to manually look for the game. This PC, local disk, then you look for your game folder. Mine is God Battle Games. This is my game folder. I press OK. Supported game version has been found, and this game is installed in your system and is supported and fully compatible with low spec experience optimization. Press OK to continue to your control panel. When you press OK, you come here. Playing low, this is the lowest you can go for performance. Then you provide your res. I'm playing on 720p. This is going to be my res. Execute. Then you exit. After that game should run better. Trust me. Let's check on our baby. Yep, your PC is feeling better. Make sure you connect. You're on the internet to be able to do this too. Don't worry, this is the paid version, which I'm sure you didn't pay for. Yep, split it up. I think I've helped you a lot, but there are many tips. Like, yep, click on Windows button and your R alphabet, Windows plus R. Then you see this button, this window here. If your keyboard is malfunctioning, you can actually go to your Windows here, go to your Windows set, Windows system, run, click on it. Then this should come out. Now type this temp, percentage sign. Do it twice. It doesn't matter if it's in caps or not in caps, it still works. Then this folder should come out. Click on everything here. Hold your shift button and delete. Shift plus delete. Press yes. The reason you're pressing shift plus delete is because you don't want it to come to your recycle bin. It's taking it direct from there out of your PC. Please don't ever forget, shift plus delete actually helps in killing viruses, and you know, just not forget that. Oh, bring up this again and type prefetch, prefetch. Okay. Open it up, prefetch, and make sure you shift plus delete again. Yep. And after that, if you haven't done it before or in a long time, you should see a load of files in that place, like many files. So delete it and you actually see an improved performance. So after doing all these steps, after you're finished doing all these steps, come here, clear memory. But I won't do it because my Bandicam will crash, so just do it, okay? After that, I also provided an FPS counter, or FPS, what do you call that? FPS. I didn't put this file called MSI Afterburner, because it actually uses your RAM and your CPU when recording your FPS, so I don't like it. So in this fraps here, you extract it here, okay? The password for the fraps is 123, okay? Don't forget, there's a file that tells you, I don't know, but just 123 password, okay? When it is here, you open fraps, do this and everything. Then after installing it, you should see your fraps here. Open this up. And also, don't forget that if you want to download your apps and your software, or anything you want, any software you want, not games though, just softwares, go to getintopc.com, okay? The link will be in the description below. Fraps.exe, yes. After you have installed it, okay? After installing this, you find this window come out. And also, I forgot to tell you that Fraps doesn't take too much RAM. Like, for example, right now I'm going to show you my RAM usage. See Fraps, this is the Fraps you want to check up, okay? Start Fraps, minimize FPS. You should just come here, turn this off, okay, so it doesn't take your RAM. Then on only FPS, okay? Then overlay hotkey is F12. Don't benchmark while you're gaming, okay? Disable this. Turn only your overlay hotkey to just show you the FPS of your games now and before, just to compare your gaming performance before and now. Minimize. Look at Fraps, just takes 21 MB of my whole RAM, okay? But that should just do for that. And also, don't forget that when you're running your softwares, okay, you come to this software here, okay, look for something called DWM. There you go. This is Windows, DirectX Windows, I don't know, just when it was here before, it was set to real time. Okay, so go to the WM here, right click on it, priority, always below normal or idle if you want to fuck it up. Okay, idle. Okay, so when you do that, you should get more Windows experience, like more speed, you know, in your experience with Windows. Okay, so I advise you, when you run your games, okay, like for example, now I want to open a game. Let me say I want to open a game right now. I minimize this, okay? Move it right here. When you open that game engine, like for now, for example, I open this game, PSP, okay? You come back here, look for that PSP. There you go, PSP Windows 64. Right click on it, priority class, always set it to high. Don't put it in real time, because this is going to be really bad, because this will push your CPU to 99% usage and then either to crash or just put set to high. For the best, just put it to high. Okay, set it to high. CPU affinity, always everything should be ticked. CPU 0, just put in default affinity, should be CPU 0, 1, 2, 3. IO priority should be set to none. Okay, this is depending on your PC. If you have a really, really strong battery, you can put it in normal. Okay, but if you are sure that you are plugged in, your PC will always be plugged into the internet, like your laptop or your PC is always plugged in, put it in high. This will give you much more FPS, like much more performance in your game. Okay, you close this up. Now these are all my PSP games. I think I have more, right? Let me check. Wait, what the fuck? Where my PSP games at? no. Wait, just give me a second, okay? My PSP games. I think I have my second hard disk. Okay. I don't know. Well, I have told you what you have to do, okay? Don't forget that step, okay? That should make your PSP to perform better, okay? So, as you can see, let me put up one game like real quick. This is a good FPS. So, if you want to also know how to get some stable, nice FPS in PSP games, just comment right in the comment box and I promise I'm gonna provide you those steps. Okay, so after doing that, I think your PC is ready to go for gaming. All your games should be set to max performance right now. So this is a bonus tip. Download this, go to google.com and download and just type Wise Game Booster. It's a free software from the company Wise. So just when you install it, you should see it. I didn't provide this in the link because I just think that, sorry, I didn't put this in the folder because I think that it won't be wise. it won't be wise to put their free game booster for you. So I actually put this happened because of my antivirus is on. No, don't bother, but when you open this, you should see everything you need to know about it. Yeah, it actually works in all your games. So just go to google.com and type Wise Game Booster. I'll provide the link in the description below. google.com Wise sorry google.com Wise Game Booster. Okay, this, so make sure that you get this so you don't lose a bar. Just get this file, Wise Game Booster. Okay, thank you for watching this video. Like this video, don't like before the video, but like it now that it actually works. If you see that this video is helpful and you need more tips and tricks for tomorrow or next, I promise to provide more tips and tricks. Just like the video, sub to my channel, and I'll do that. And yeah, that's everything for the video. And don't forget to also follow Lost Gamer and Levitation for the Levity Okay, sorry, I'm stammering. Levitation 4D on YouTube, because he actually has more of this. No, I have more of this. I combined all the YouTubers, you know, info and made it in one video, so that's why the video is so long. So just please don't forget to subscribe to the channel and like the video. Yeah, thank you for tuning in today. I'll see you in the next. Peace out.
Love you. I love you.